What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and play the Farming Valley Minecraft mod pack. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Not everyone loves the combat aspect of Minecraft, and Farming Valley is here to help. This is a modpack adventure that leads you to make an entire town, complete quests from a goddess, and so much more. There's hardly any combat, but there are still plenty of new mobs, items, and materials to keep you preoccupied, so it's the perfect pack for the more low-key players that are looking for a more relaxed version of the game. Head to CurseForge and press download for your operating system, and then save and open this file to begin the installation. Once it's finished, run the launcher and enter Browse Modpacks in the menu, and then type in Farming Valley in the search bar and press Install when you find it. Wait for all of the files to download, and then click Play from the My Modpack section to load the pack. Head towards your Apex server panel and find the Game File section. And when you find it, click the currently selected option to reveal a drop-down menu. Continue to type Farming Valley in the text box and then click it again to begin the installation. Press Change Version and choose to create a new world in the following prompts. And after that, you can click Restart Now to begin loading the mod pack. Once that's done, join the server with your Farming Valley profile in CurseForge. Now, when you enter your world, you're going to notice major differences from normal Minecraft. This is due to the unique creatures, biomes, sky, vegetation, and lots of other aspects. When viewing your inventory, you're going to see multiple books to read through that will greatly help you in getting started in building the farming town. The first book to keep and review is the task book in your inventory, as this provides you with detailed information on what to expect. Using this will guide you along the journey, but they aren't entirely quests. Besides this, there is a guidebook to use later on after you've collected some resources. Starting off your new adventure requires you to collect some basic resources, mainly iron ingots. These materials will be used to create a bucket, which will need to be filled with water. There are plenty of resources to collect, so make sure you have chests to store them all. And once you've obtained a water bucket, you're ready to begin the first steps. Now that you have useful and essential resources, it's time to start activating the Harvest Goddess. This NPC will guide you through the adventure and provide blueprints for your town. You're going to need 3 flowers, 1 flower pot, 1 stick, and 2 water buckets. Afterwards, find a flat area and make 2 holes with a block in the middle, and then you can fill each hole with your water buckets. Place 1 flower at the top of the middle block and 1 at the bottom, and then put the flower pot in the middle and add your last flower inside of it. Now just right-click the pot with your stick to get a new flower, and once you have that, drop it into one of the water holes. If it's successful, the Harvest Goddess will appear for you to spark dialogue. After summoning the goddess, talking with her reveals that you need 2 dozen logs. This is required to obtain your first blueprint, so start mining trees down to complete the quest. Once you've collected enough, either summon or talk to her again for the reward. When you have the blueprint, right-click it in your hand at the spot you want the house. Afterwards, shift and right-click to confirm the placement so an NPC can start building it. Continue to use your task book to know what else needs to be done, and proceed collecting blueprints from the Harvest Goddess. This is how you and others can expand the town, including the NPCs. After progressing far enough, you'll notice unique items are going to be gifted to you. These can include watering cans and hardy turnip seeds to start your farm. There is one important NPC to always have in your town. This is a blacksmith, giving you the chance to sell and buy important items or materials to continue advancing in the journey. There's also a general store that mimics the same concept, but with different resources. In cases where the mod pack isn't loading on the server, make sure you've selected the correct Farming Valley pack in the Game File section. If you're still having issues, reset the server before trying again, since this will delete any files that might not be working with the new pack. When you select the modpack in the game file area of your panel, make sure to create a new world in the following prompt. Once this is done, restart the server so the new world can generate without any further problems. Farming Valley is the perfect modpack for the more low-key friends in your group. The relaxing atmosphere and the lack of combat is the perfect combination of fun but exciting gameplay, and you'll always have something to do in this world.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.